Today on How to Catch a Fish, we're heading onto the Swan River to target big black bream. This show takes people just like you out to my secret spots to catch their dream fish. And today's challenge is to get around those pesky blowfish and onto a huge bream using a very special bait.
Probably 38 centimetres, and you always get the big ones on mussels. Yeah, I've been fishing since I was about 7 years old, and ever since then I've just loved it, but I've never been able to catch a big Swan River black bream. It's funny because I've been working on charter boats for a few years now, and I've caught some pretty big fish out deep, like Samson fish, Jewfish, pink snapper, all sorts of stuff, but still I've never been able to catch a big Swan River black bream. I've had some wacky adventures over the years, fished in some pretty crazy locations. I've even caught sharks in the Swan, but still never got that big black bream. And if Steve could show me how to do it, I'd be really stoked.
Lockie was ready to catch that big bream, but to catch your dream fish, you've first got to be perfectly prepared. And that meant a visit to a tackle store. And there's nowhere better than Ranger Camping and Outdoors to get everything you need. Oh, so much fun stuff to look at. But for bream, you won't need to spend a fortune on fancy gadgets. You can catch bream on any outfit, but I like a small spinning reel matched up with a light 6 to 7 foot bream rod. Although you can use any type of line on your reel, including cheap mono, I always use fire line because it's low stretch and you'll feel everything happening down there. Join your fire line to a leader. Mono's okay, but for better results, I like to use 6 to 8 pound fluorocarbon. To your fluorocarbon, you'll be attaching a single hook with a bent shank, like these Kamikatsu worm G-locks. Get a couple of different sizes, around 1-0, for different size baits, and you'll see why that bend is important a little later on. What? You expect me to teach you how to catch a bream and pay for your tackle? What do you think this is? The great part about this type of fishing is that having a boat isn't really an advantage. I've caught just as many bream using this special bait from shore as I have from a boat. And Lockie was just like Maccabi Diva at the Melbourne Cup Barrier, but you just can't rush into it. You need to take into account all of the conditions to be successful. The tide is quite important, and I like to fish halfway through the rising tide right up until it's full and a couple of hours after. Low tides are usually hard work. Moon phases can affect bream too, with the new, half and full moons all good. Waxing moons work best for me. For some reason, I always do it tougher when it's waning. Amazingly, you can do well at any time of the day. Wind doesn't seem to make much difference, but I do look for a rising barometer, especially if it's 1024 kilopascals or better. Just look at all of those bream! But this footage wasn't shot in some faraway country river. It was shot in the Swan and only a couple of k's from the centre of the city. They school in their hundreds under almost every jetty, pylon, yacht club, bridge, anywhere there's structure, that's where you'll find bream, but not in the open. Right underneath it. They hang underneath for protection, and that's also where they get their food. They like to eat prawns, small fish, they'll scavenge, they'll eat crabs, but they also like to grab mussels that hang off the structure, rip them off, crush them up, and eat the soft insides. But the problem with using soft baits is that you've got the blowies that school with them to deal with, and they'll eat them so fast you'll never get a bream. So we need to adapt, we need to find a way to get your bait down through the blowies and to the bream. I guaranteed Lockie the fish would be there, but I didn't really tell him that part of the job was hunting down my bait of choice, whole mussels from around the pylons. That'll teach him to be tall. He's got the perfect arms for ripping those suckers off the wood though. You have your successes and your failures. It's smugness just isn't a good look. But we soon scrounged enough to get us to the next step on our hunt for his 40-centimetre bream, the right baiting technique. Now we've got our bait. The key to this bream fishing from the jetties using mussels is to bait your mussel properly. Now a lot of people might want to open it up and use the soft inside part, but you're just going to catch blowfish that way. So come down here and I'll show you exactly how to use this sneaky little technique to use the whole mussel. The first thing we have to do is prepare our mussel. And to start with, we take that piece of weed and we pull it out like that. It does two things. It cleans it and also makes a hole in the flat side. We bait up down the flat side. First things first, get the point of our hook, push it into the hole that you made by pulling out the weed, and then rotate it around and then back out here, just like that. And now we push it through all the way right to the bend, and then we just adjust it around. So finally we end up with a mussel that looks like that. Now this might look crazy, but believe me, a mussel baited up like that is going to look far more natural to a bream than the inside of a mussel floating down.
Oh, we've got one.
After the break, you'll see exactly how this amazing technique actually catches those big bream.
If you'd like some insider fishing knowledge, why not pick up a copy of my book called How to Catch a Fish? Inside the 160 pages with 200 fantastic fishing photos, you'll find all of my secrets about fishing in Western Australia and across the whole of Australia. It's only $15.95 and you can pick it up at a newsagent or your Ranger Camping and Outdoor store. We've got a pylon. We've got so much structure here, it's the perfect place for bream. Just about every jetty in the Swan River is full of bream most times of the year. But they're not out there, they're under here. They can be swimming around close as well, but the best place to start is by dropping right there, right on the corner, and just let your mussel float down all the way to the bottom. And you can see the blowfish try and destroy it. If that was a soft bait, I'd have a blowfish already and almost no chance of bream. But they won't get that because they can't get through the tough shell of the mussel. Now this is great for kids because there's no casting involved. All they've got to be able to do is drop the mussel off the side of the jetty. And once it's on the bottom, you leave it there. How much easier does fishing get than this? Oh, we've got one. I'm getting out nice and low, not for any real technique reason, mainly through panic. Oh, it's a good fish, dude, it's a good fish. How's that? Lockie, you didn't believe me, but I told you it was gonna work. Oh, it's all tangled around. I need the net.
Nice.
Why, thank you, very expertly done. And
you're not crazy.
That's an upside down bream. We might just detangle him and give you a look. Looking inside his gob there, you'll see there's these two holding teeth at the front and then rows of peg-like teeth. Hopefully you can see them. Whoop, he tried to peg-like teeth my thumb that time, but see, that's how he crushes the mussels. And when there's so much natural food under the jetty, looking at those teeth, they're a mussel feeder, mussels under the jetty, fish in the mussels. We're gonna pop this one back. Don't just plonk him in, really just glide the fish back down and he'll be fine.
If you were to give one tip above all else for black bream, what's it going to be?
I don't know about black bream in general, but certainly with this kind of fishing, it's definitely patience and not moving around too much. Leave it sit there right on the bottom and give it a good 2 or 3 minutes and then move it and then move it and then move it and then move it. And just because you haven't got something for, was that a bite? Yes, it was.
I guess I'll have to move it, then move it,
then move it. Just because you haven't got something for half an hour doesn't mean all of a sudden you shouldn't be ready for some action. Watch me catch it now.
Nice.
Look at that, Lockie. See the line just moving in a different direction?
You're joking.
Sometimes it's real gentle. Yes. Oh yeah, here we go, look at this.
Fall off, come on. Come on, around the pylon.
No such luck, mate. Look at this, he's a nice fish. He's a
You're
nice
gonna have to
fish.
Be nice now, I've got to net it.
No, actually, I think I'm gonna lift this one.
Oh yeah. Come on, break, break. You're gonna break now.
No.
Oh.
He's done it again. Isn't that a magnificent black bream? Probably 38 centimeters, and you always get the big ones on mussels. And have a look at this. I'm gonna show you this. The hook always sits right in the corner of the mouth. So they're easy to release, but it's in there so firmly because these are great hooks that you're not gonna lose many fish as a result. We'll get that hook out. We'll pop him back too. Lockie, it's all right, mate. You're gonna get one. It's all right, he will, I promise. You got him out. Oh, he's gone into the pylon. You can do it, Lockie, you can do it.
After the break, Lockie finally hooks his big bream, but can he land it?
The knot I've been using for all the rigs I've tied today is called a uni knot. If you haven't tied one before, it's dead easy and you really should learn it. Now we start by taking our main line and putting it through the eye of the hook, and then we pinch it together. That's the key thing, pinching it right there. Then we take our tag and we push. Push to make a loop. Don't try and make a loop, just push it in and it will go. Then we pinch them all together. Then we wrap down the main line and the loop. Three times. We've got three, and then we pull the tag in and it slips. Then we pull the main line and it slips. And that is a uni knot. I use three turns for heavier lines, seven, eight, even 10 turns for very light lines and braid. All right, let's get back to Lockie and see if he can't catch his dream bream.
So you're pretty adamant on using fluorocarbon for a leader, but the water's pretty dirty.
Well, it is. Actually, fluorocarbon, what it is, it's like a monofilament type of leader, but it's got the same light transmission properties as water. So in water, in theory, it turns invisible. Now, in dirty water like this, Lockie, yeah, I reckon you could get away sometimes with using a leader that's not fluoro, but I like to use it, and I've definitely seen on days when the water's really dirty, if I'm using 6 pound fluorocarbon, which is my choice, someone next to me, even using 8 or 10 pound fluorocarbon, won't get anywhere near the same bites and definitely not the same hookup. So, yep, I reckon you would always use it just to be safe, and 6 pound really is enough. Mate, I know you're looking frustrated there, but don't give up. It's actually not as easy as it looks just to sit here and go, bang, there's a bream. One thing you are doing, I notice, is that you are getting bites. But instead of letting the fish take it and run with it, and you saw me do that in the last fish, he's actually striking because you get really tense. So just try and relax and ease into it. Yeah, that's
it. Tense.
It's all tense. Be okay, you're gonna get one, don't worry.
Think I gotta run.
Just ease the hook in, he's got him! Yep. He's got him!
Finally.
Finally, indeed. You got him out. Oh, he's gone under the pylon. You can do it, Lockie. You can do it. Oh, that's a beautiful fish. Woohoo.
Oh, it took a while. But oh, he's still not in.
It took a while. It's still taking a while. That's nice, mate.
Oh, man.
He's not 40, but he's close. Woo. Oh, that's superb. I'd just like to say congratulations.
Thank you, Steve.
Well, I might be good at finding the fish, but I'm no good at guessing the size. It was in fact 40 centimetres, 41 to be exact, and we ended up with one happy angler. So happy, in fact, that Lockie was keen to put his big bream back to breed and grow even bigger. But what about this student out fishing the teacher deal? I couldn't have that, so I kept at it, and half an hour later, my mussel was slammed. It was the best bream fight I'd ever had, and as it glided into the net, I was the happy angler, with my PB to date. a 47 centimetre bream from shore on whole mussels in the middle of the day. Now that's how you catch a fish.
Well, that's it for this episode, and I really hope you learned something along the way. If you'd like to learn more about fishing this great state of Western Australia, why not pick up my book? It's called How to Catch a Fish, and it's 160 pages of all the information you need to catch awesome fish right across Western Australia. Well, that's it. So we'll see you next time on How to Catch a Fish.